Nod, if you can hear me. Look up, please. Very good. How do you feel now? Can you speak? What is your name? When were you born? Can you recall? Good. Now then. Please try to relax. There is plenty of time. I need to tell you something. Please listen and try not to panic. You've been in a coma for quite some time. Yes, yes, I know. You would like to know how long. I'm afraid it's been 9 years. Damn it! Nosso coma! Nosso coma! Nosso coma! Nurse! Calm down. Calm down. Try not to panic. Wait a second. Try not to panic. You'll be all right.
How do you feel?
I have stated that the reason for the crash was an as yet inexplicable fire in mid-flight. The search has ended with a confirmed death toll of 94 and another 30.
It's been 1 week since you came to. Now, let's try getting you out of that bed. Nurse.
And sources suggest this may be part of a cover-up.
Don't worry. You've lost some strength, but we've been maintaining your muscle mass through massages, CPM therapy, and EMS. Now, I need to explain something to you, but you mustn't be alarmed. 9 years ago, you were injured in an explosion. Upon examination, we discovered 108 foreign bodies embedded within you. In addition to shrapnel, we also found fragments of human bone and human teeth. Most of it was removed, but some of the fragments still remain. They are located near your heart and in your skull. The fragments are lodged deep within your cerebral cortex. We couldn't give you an MRI, the metal, you see. But even if we were to extract it, you would most likely suffer a brain hemorrhage. Mental and physical impairment are unavoidable. However, your current status is not life-threatening. One more thing. This X-ray is on your upper body. You better look now. Best to understand your situation sooner than later. I know it's difficult, but please look down. It's best to see with your own eyes. Be brave. Nosso coma! Grigor! Try to calm down! Calm down! Please! Calm down! It's gonna be okay!